Well, first, thank you everyone for being here, especially like the families, the parents, the grandparents, the alumni, friends, just supporters of the program. You guys like make this dinner possible. You make everything that we do possible. Without you guys, we don't have everything. But especially like having your guys and your girls come to OCU, it's huge. So I want to make sure to say thank you. Like it all helps. For us, for the season wise, we're a little updated with that. We had Wichita out here for a scrimmage to begin the season after we came back from spring break down in Natchitoches, Louisiana. We had a good week down there. I think there's a new venue that they just built down there. The town was very excited to have us for Natchitoches. University of Georgia and Texas rowing clubs were down there the same week as us. So we got some photos, and there were some newspaper stories down there about all the rowing programs that kind of go down there and visit. So we had a good week down there. Came back, we had great water to race in Wichita and do a little scrimmage here with them. The following week, we headed up to Marietta, Ohio. So that's what I'm talking about, the field. We wish we had a field I could have just soccer balls and everything, load up into a van. We have to take the rears and everything off and put all our stuff on a truck and trailer and have to transport it. And when we get there, we have to reset everything back up for ourselves to go out there. And then we have to deal with the weather conditions. It was running fast there. The water was moving. They've had a lot of rain in Ohio, so flooding and everything. So those were the conditions when we got there. We had a good time, actually. Our assistant coach, we had to eat dinner at his parents' hosted us for dinner. And everyone had a good time with that. And one of our other rowers, Craig, he's from Ohio. His parents were able to come down and see everyone there. So we went there. We raced Grand Valley and Notre Dame and Marietta College, as well as the women's Ohio State women's club team. So that was a good start. It was a good opening experience for us. It was good for us to line up and duel two, three teams, work on our start. We have some learning experiences there, how to manage our race and everything. Heading forward, we are going to be headed down to Oak Ridge, Tennessee, April 21st to 22nd. We'll go down to that for SEER, the Southern Intercollegiate Rowing Association Regatta Championship, which we've been going to in the past few years. So we look forward to going there. We've had a race that I don't think since the program started they've gone up to. We're all going to Topeka this year, which is a close race for us, being 4.5 hours away, being as part of the country. So we're all going up there and hopefully sharpen up whatever we learn from SEER. And then we're also going to go to Death Valley Regatta, which is in Philadelphia, May 11th and 12th. So that's be a good regatta. I know a couple people have gotten to experience it here. Vlad and Eric went in for the men's team last year, and we went in a 4 last year. So they're all going to get to try that regatta out for some people for the first time, I believe. It's a good experience. It's a hard place to race. There's a lot of teams. It's one of the oldest college regattas out there. I think it's in the 112th or 13th year of it running. Multiple teams from all over the country come down, and some teams from Canada as well. So we'll go out there, and with that, we have a goal of hopefully putting a men's 4 at the IRA after that, which will then take place June 1st through 3rd, and that will be over in Princeton. That's in Princeton, New Jersey. So we have a little bit of travel coming up from going down to Tennessee, to Philadelphia, to Jersey, and then Kansas. That's why I said that's close. For us, we did the Ohio, we had to hop on the road for 5 hours after that race was over. So being able to be 4.5 hours away, be able to come home and actually get back to the dorms and back to our own beds and everything that night will be a good thing for us. That's pretty much where our season is. I'll bring Mike back up, and first we'll do a presentation to the juniors, and we'll talk about the pins and kind of the history with the jackets, and the seniors will get their letters as well. So turn back over to Mike.